Last episode, Cadillac Bill Show. It's been a wild ride. Had a lot of fun. Had some laughs. Hope you people at home enjoyed every episode. Because it's wild and weird. Just like the rest of us. Cool.
Hey, you guys, welcome to the show. We've got some great stuff, as always, on this show, on this particular episode. And I would like to start off by talking about the very first silent movie star. Her name is Florence Lawrence. You guys ever heard of Florence Lawrence? Florence Lawrence. You guys probably never heard of Florence Lawrence. She is from Hamilton, and she's considered the very first Hollywood movie star. She was born in 1886, and she ended up moving to Hollywood. Well, she first started making films in 1906 for Thomas Edison, and then about a year after that, she moved to Hollywood, and within 1907 or 8, she was working for the Biograph Company in Los Angeles, in Hollywood, and she became, within about a year or two, she was the biggest movie star in Hollywood at the time, and she made 250 films. And she was the first movie star ever to have her name on the credits for the films. Because before that, they never bothered crediting any of the actors. She was the first movie star, wow, man or woman, to have her name in big for the titles.
Wow.
And she's from Hamilton.
So she was the first one to do that, Florence Lauren.
With Biograph Films Presents Florence Lawrence or whatever, in whatever, 250 different films. She was the first to appear in a comedy series. She was Mrs. Jones. She made 12 of those comedy films. So that was the very first movie series ever. And she was also the first film publicity stunt ever in the history of films. In about 1909, she and her publicist decided she was going to stage her death, pretend she'd been hit by a streetcar, just to get people out to the theaters, and then she showed up and said, no, it was all a, I'm fine, it was all a misunderstanding.
It's kind of unbelievable and kind of like morbid.
A little scamish, wouldn't you say, Bill?
Seriously, the story of Florence Lawrence is wonderful. And the greatest thing about it is she's from here in Hamilton, born in Hamilton.
Wow. Yeah.
And you guys have heard of Mary Pickford, eh?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. She was before Mary Pickford. She was negotiating with other studios at the time because she was such a huge star to be on a different, maybe get paid a bit more. And they found out about it. The studio, Biograph found out about it, so they kicked her out. And she ended up moving to Imp Studios after that. But then Biograph ended up hiring a Toronto girl called Mary Pickford.
Wow, interesting.
I didn't know Mary Pickford was from Toronto.
She was from Toronto. Florence Lawrence was from about 30 miles from Toronto, Hamilton. So that's the story of Florence Lawrence, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more. But right now we're going to go to England and see what's going on with our reporter there in England. And it's Dom. Hey there, Dom. There you are.
I'm Dom, and you find me surrounded by water. Water plays an enormous part in the importance of what makes Britain and how the history has determined the country that we're in today. We are, of course, islands, and islands and the sea have been the principal point of defence. We think of how many times that this country has been saved from invasion because of the sea. If you think about it from this point of view, over 2,000 years, the first 1,000 years was the history of invasion of the British Isles. We think of Romans, we think of Saxons, we think of Vikings, of course, and ultimately the Normans. And after the Normans settled here, it becomes, in the second 1,000 years, a history of defence. And the sea has played an enormous role in the fact of keeping Britain free from invading powers. The history of Europe is the history of the movement of peoples from east to west. And the British Isles are a case in point. The invasions come from the east and they push the indigenous populations to the west, which is why the Celtic peoples, the original British peoples, are all on the western side in Cornwall, Wales, and the west side of Scotland. And on that note, so here I am, fully immersed in water, talking about the British Isles. It's back over to you, Bill. I'm Dom for the Cadillac Bill Show.
Thank you, Dom. Great stuff.
More information from Don. I love him.
And right there in the swimming pool. Didn't he look great in the swimming pool?
Awesome. He looked quite safe, just like England did.
Nice and safe in the swimming pool. Safe from invaders. That's our reporter in England. Safe from invaders.
Safe from invaders. But the famous quote, no man is an island.
Correct.
Except Dom.
Except Dom.
Yeah. So, yeah, Florence Lawrence, by the way, she was not just a movie star, she was the first, one of the first women, one of the first people ever to own an automobile. In 1909, she bought a car, and she loved driving. She was an avid driver, and she, you think her being the first movie star is a big deal. She ended up being the very first person to invent turn signals for cars. Mm. That was in 19...
As a result of the first car accident?
1912, she invented a turn signal. I'm going to actually read you this because I really want to get this correct. She was such a successful actress, she was able to buy her own car. And in 1914, she developed a mechanical signaling arm, and with the press of a button, raised or lowered a flag on the car's rear bumper that told other drivers which way the car was going to turn. After that, Lawrence devised a rudimentary brake signal that worked on the same principle. When a driver pressed the brake, a stop sign flipped up from the back bumper, but because she never bothered to file patents for her work, Lawrence never got the recognition she deserved.
Mm. Wow, that's interesting.
Yeah, so however, though, she technically wasn't the first person to invent the turn signal, because in 1909, a British man actually invented similar little arms flip up on either side of the car, but he never patented his either, and it's unlikely, this is a historian of car history said, it's unlikely Florence Lawrence ever knew about his invention. So what she did was, she wasn't copying anyone, she really did invent the turn signal. Okay, so we're now going to go to Janet, and Janet's tidbits.
Tidbits.
Let's see what Janet's got for us.
Yeah. Welcome, everyone. This is Janet. I'm on with Cadillac Bill Show. It's this Janet's Tidbit. A quick call mention, this is winter time, and everyone needs to warm up and dress for safety. That's right, your winter boots. Take a hard look before the snow comes. See that you got safety boots that are safe to walk on ice and snow. Take time to check for any breaks. If you need to go repair them, go get them replaced if they are not in good shape. Check your coats to make sure that everyone has a warm hat, a scarf, and mitts, and plenty of them if you need to. Make sure your child, no matter what the age is, make sure that that child has the proper footwear, snow boots, their snow pants, whatever, so he or she is kept warm. As you can see, I have my winter hat on and my winter mitts. I got two pairs of mitts on, keep my little fingers warm. I got my winter coat and I got a hoodie on. So I just thought, that just lets you know how cold it is out here. Right now the snow has gone away, but that too can come right back. If you're going to please have your walks cleared of ice and snow. That is for the safety, not for yourself, but for anyone that comes to your door, like your delivery people, your mailman, your newspaper carrier, that may come to the doors at night. And so take time. It only takes seconds to take a fall, but it also takes another second to make sure you got the proper ice salt. If you don't have ice salt, use the cat litter. Cat litter does not track in on carpet like ice salt would. When you take off your boots after you get in the house, dry them with either a paper towel or a rag, or also your hair dryer. Leave them out so they can dry out, so they're ready to go when you want to go outdoors. Again, I'm going to sign off. I hope you have a wonderful winter. You be safe and stay warm. This is Janet Tidbits signing off again. Have a wonderful night. Thank you. This is from Cadillac Bill Show. I'm going to sign off and happy sales. Do not fall.
All right, Janet, and winter safety. Mitts, gloves,
boots,
scarves,
salt,
hats,
jackets, sweaters,
everything. We are winding down, and I wanted to conclude by letting you guys know that Florence Lawrence, despite her huge success, it really lasted only a few years, and she ended up basically no money. She took her life, committed suicide in 1938 by eating ant paste, because it had arsenic in it. Mm. So she was then buried in an unmarked grave in California, in Los Angeles. And it wasn't until, I think, the 1970s or something, that Roddy McDowell found out about her being in an unmarked grave, and Roddy McDowell paid for her to have a proper headstone and everything. So she's now buried. Thanks to Roddy McDowell, she's now honored. And I'm hoping the world will see this episode, and a few more people will now hear about Florence Lawrence, the Biograph girl, who was the very first movie star in the world, and she was born and came from Hamilton.
Yay, Hamilton!
So we're winding down. I want to kind of honor us a wee bit. You guys all know the Creeping Bent Orchestra, of course. You probably really don't know the guys behind the show, the cameramen. And we got Johnny Angel. Johnny, come up here for a sec. I want you guys all to meet Johnny. He's the guy behind a lot of the segments you see. Johnny. So this is Johnny.
Thank you very much. I can't admit or I can't deny
that I have anything to do with Bill's show. But I will admit one thing, I've had a lot of fun. Thank you very much, Bill.
Thanks, Johnny. And also behind, over there, you can film Danny. Our studio camera guy is Danny Z. So all of the studio stuff you see, that's Danny Z filming. And by the way, most of the music you hear on the show was recorded at Danny's studio, Blue Tilt. So thanks, Johnny. You get back there.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.
And keep filming there, Johnny. So, okay, I just want to say it's been a wonderful season, a wonderful 4 years. Next week there's going to be the best of season 1, 2, and 3. So we're not really done quite yet. Although coming up now is the end of Downton Alley with the Rats. So there'll be the conclusion of Downton Alley. And the band's gonna play a little number, are you?
Yeah, yes. Sure.
So, Hamilton, ciao, yo. We'll Peace see out. You around.
Peace ciao, out.
Yo. Ciao, yo.
1, 2, show.
I love it, man. It was excellent. I learned so much. It's like a history lesson, music lessons.
It's a total learning experience, isn't it?
Unbelievable. I just can't get enough.
Can't get enough of your drugs.
Florence from Hamilton. Who would have guessed? First movie star in the entire world, right from here. Amazing.
What do you say about Florence Lawrence?
Great.
Who's a cat that won't cop out? When is danger all about? Chef?
Right on!
Right on, baby. He's a complicated man, but no one understands him but his woman. Shane Shaft.
It's Shaft!
Excuse me. That's a wrap.
Oh, I'm gonna get my cup.
It did seem a little darker.
What a relief to be home. I miss this old box.
Dear Mrs. Huge, I do hope you've had some time to yourself while we've been away.
I've tackled a few jobs that get forgotten about when the house is full, like patching the holes in the walls that the family has been chewing through.
Jolly good. Jolly good. Marvelous. Marvelous. Pregnant? You're pregnant?
Yes, well, sort of. You needn't be quite so shocked.
But you just had a litter 18 months ago.
Yes, I suppose I did. Well, I'm pregnant again now.
It's unusual, obviously. You understand that rats go through a certain change.
Thank you, Doctor. I know quite as much as I need to about all that.
Well, sometimes it can result in a surge of fertility, for want of a better word.
How long has she?
Hard to be precise, but I'd say she's about 4 weeks gone. It'll begin to show soon.
And I don't suppose there's any way of knowing if they're...
Rats.
I want to say I'll make provisions for you if there's a boy in the litter and you get pushed out.
Don't worry. If any rat living understands the strength of the entail, it's me.
I can give you Crawley House for life and all the wood chips, if it's a help.
Well, that is generous. It may just be a cardboard box, but it's certainly an improvement from a hole in the wall or under a dumpster by the docks.
Mr. Carson, we are planning to install a telephone system here at the house.
But why would we ever want a telephone at Downton, my lord?
Well, they have their uses. You could speak to the housekeeper in London, order some cheese or more wood chips, that sort of thing.
I suppose I could do that. I just hope I've not failed in my management of keeping the house stocked with fresh rotting fruit, my lord.
Not at all. But the telephone is here now at Downton, and the girls got used to it in our rat hole in London.
Very well, my lord. Will you join us, Mrs. Bird?
I don't mind if I do.
I'm not sure Mrs. Ratmore would like that, Mr. Carson. Cook always eats separate. That's what she says. Isn't that right, Mrs. Huge?
Let the kitchen maids have theirs on their own. They're mice, but birds can stay with us.
How about some soup? It's water and bird seed.
Ooh, very nice.
Oh, jeez, that damn hat.
Perhaps Mrs. Bird would like some delicious scraps we found behind the dumpster.
How the devil does one work these things? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Operator, can I help you?
Oh, hello. Could you connect me to Downton Alley 674, please?
Ma'am, you were calling from Downton 674.
Oh, yes. Jolly good. Well, can you connect me to Mr. Carson, please?
Who?
He's here in the house somewhere. Could you connect us?
Ma'am, this is the operator. I'm in Dorset. I can't connect you to someone in your own house.
Well, ask him if he knows where he is.
Do you know where he is?
No, I do not.
He's the butler of Downton Alley.
Is this a crank call? Ma'am, I must kindly ask you to refrain from using the British telephone system for such trivialities.
Could I ask you something, sir? Only, I get the feeling that a war's on the way.
I'm afraid we all do.
And when it comes, I want to be really useful to my country. So I've been thinking, what could be more useful than what you do? Bringing rats back to health.
Well, we're looking for volunteers to train at the territorial rodent hospitals, if that's what you mean.
It's exactly what I mean. I want to be a vet.
Will you not be missed here?
Maybe. But there'll be many more rats being born here at Downton every day. And I won't be missed. And eventually we'll all be scurrying off to fight. The younger rats anyway.
As you wish. I'll make inquiries.
Thank you very much, Doctor.
Uncle Rat gave his consent. That's the way that marriage went.